Welcome back. As we promised, the whole episode is totally dedicated to the important visit of President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi to France upon the invitation of his counterpart Emmanuel Macron, and the two important topics which are going to be discussed, the transition period in Sudan and the African economies, particularly after the repercussions of COVID-19. Upon his arrival in Paris, President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi met with Abdel Fattah al-Burhan, the president of the Transitional Sovereign Council of Sudan, to tackle the whole issue ahead of the important summit, which is going to gather more than 30 leaders from around the world and heads of governments. Well, to shed more light on both topics, we are very much delighted to have with us via phone Ambassador Ali Al-Hifni, former Assistant Foreign Minister. A very good morning to you, sir.
Good morning, Mr. Nadreen.
Sir, let's start with the very first important topic which is going to be discussed today, which is supporting Sudan. And as I said, there was a very important meeting of President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi when he received yesterday, upon his arrival in Paris, the head of the Transitional Sovereign Council of Sudan, Abdel Fattah al-Burhan. Tell us more about this important topic which is going to be discussed today.
Well, the visit is of a particular importance for several reasons, one of which has to do with that conference that is going to take place related to the backing and the support that the international community is going to offer. Mm-hmm. For the transition period in Sudan.
Yes.
Egypt has invested a lot in its relations with Sudan. It has backed the Sudanese causes as if they were Egyptian causes at different international forums, whether to lift the Sudan from the list of the
terrorist organizations.
Exactly.
Yes.
Or having to do with the critical financial situation prevailing in Sudan at the current time. So, in fact, the presence of Egypt at that conference is important, and the presence of the President al-Sisi in person is very significant. And the conference is coming at, as I said, a crucial time as Sudan is facing many challenges at the time being. And it needs badly the support, especially the financial and economic support of the international community, in such way that Sudan could proceed with the transition period in a manner that will allow the people and the government, Transition Council in Sudan, to achieve the required goals by the end of that transition period. But it's very relieving to see that Sudan is regaining its original and natural place within the international community, enjoying normal ties with all countries, all institutions, especially institutions of financial and economic nature. So,
and,
please.
Yes, sir.
It's important to be there to attend that conference. Of course, the meeting yesterday between the president and Mr. Fattah Burhan was important to jointly prepare for that conference, but also to discuss or to proceed with their discussions pertaining to several issues having to do with the Sudan and Egypt relations, having to do with the...
And many topics of mutual concern, if you permit me, sir, to interrupt. And, of course, one of the topics which topped the agenda of talks, the controversial Ethiopian dam, because Egypt and Sudan agreed and renewed their commitment to preserve the national interests of both countries. Water is a matter of life and death, and this is an issue which is going to be reaffirmed again and again in all international arenas and in all occasions. But let's move, sir, if you permit me, to the second important topic, which is going to be the African economies or financing African states, particularly after the COVID-19 repercussions and its negative impacts on African economies. How do you see the timing, sir, of this issue, and how do you see inviting more than 30 world leaders to participate in this conference?
Well, it is, of course, of a very particular importance as well. And in fact, we as Africans, we have been working on that with our international partners, in particular France, but other partners as well, in such a way that we could minimize the effect of COVID-19 on our economies in Africa, most of which were vulnerable. And of course, the sudden outreach of COVID-19 in Africa has caused a sort of a destabilization to several countries. Mm-hmm. They were not prepared, especially from a medical point of view, from health point of view. Mm-hmm. This is why one of the things that were two things. The first, if you do recall that President Fatah has attended some virtual meetings, summits, in preparation for meetings of the G20, where the matter of the African debt were discussed. Egypt has required, has requested to alleviate and even to cancel the debts of the least developed countries in Africa, but also to reschedule the interest that were Africans were expected to settle interest on those loans that they have gotten from different governments and different institutions. So this is one thing. The other thing, if you recall also, that we have attended the President Al-Sisi in person, attended also the Heads of State, yes, African Union Bureau,
yep,
to discuss about COVID.
Yes, sir. Ambassador Hifni? Hello? It seems that we have lost contact with Ambassador Hifni. Right after the short break, we are going to return back. We hope that we are going to have him once again via phone.